So what's better, streaming your audio and video or optical disc? That's the question we're going to be answering in today's video. Hey folks, I'm Gene Delasalo with Audioholics. And you know, I get this question all the time about, is streaming as good now as optical disc? Is it better? What is the best way to get the maximum performance out of your home theater system? Well, to answer that question, it really depends on what you're comparing. Are you doing optical UHD or are you just doing a regular Blu-ray or DVD? If it's just regular DVD or even Blu-ray, then streaming does have some advantages. But if you really want the best quality, both in audio and both in video, optical disc UHD is still the way to go. And here's why. You take a disc like Roger Waters' The Wall, which is in Atmos. It actually has lossless audio. It's true HD. It's Dolby TrueHD with Atmos. Now, if you were to play this on a streaming device today, let's say Tidal, for example, everybody's excited now because Tidal is streaming in Atmos on very select music. That's awesome. I've been waiting for streaming in 5.1 and even Atmos for many years, and I'm very happy to see Tidal is one of the first to do that. But you do have to realize something. When Tidal is streaming in Atmos, or when your Roku HD, when that's streaming in Atmos, or your Amazon Fire TV, or your Apple TV, currently they're all streaming in Dolby Digital Plus, not Dolby True HD. So Dolby Digital Plus is really good audio. It's much better than the original Dolby Digital that came out in the 90s. Dolby Digital from the 90s sounded pretty bad. It was very high compression rates. And DTS always sounded better to me and to other reviewers because it had less compression. It just sounded more natural. So Dolby Digital Plus gives you the data rates that are as good as the regular DTS and even above that in some cases, but not quite as good as lossless Dolby True HD. There are compromises. So the very best fidelity you're going to get today is still through optical disc, through Dolby True HD or DTS HD lossless. So that's one advantage that these optical discs still have if you have a UHD player. You know, here's another great example. This recording I have from Jeanette, it's a Monk recording. If you really want to hear incredible uncompressed fidelity in 5.1 and beyond, this kind of stuff is great. Steven Wilson, for example, most of his discs are in DTS HD 5.1, and then I use the upmixer, the DSU upmixer, and I have it in Atmos, and it's lossless, and the fidelity is amazing. But I love streaming, and I'm not bashing streaming at all. I love stuff like Roku, for example. They're easy to use. You have so much content on it. And let's face it, you're getting incredible quality through streaming, through Netflix and through Amazon Prime. You watch shows like Stranger Things, or you watch, I like The Tick. Unfortunately, it didn't make it past the second season, but man, the quality of that was awesome. There's a bunch of shows now that are streaming in Atmos, and I would say that if you want to binge watch, streaming is definitely the way to go because you don't want to buy all these optical discs. So streaming will get you really close to having that UHD experience. There is, of course, some artifacting that can still happen, even when you're streaming in 4K. Sometimes you get freeze-ups, even when you have a great internet connection. I know during this whole COVID-19 thing, Netflix was using a lot of bandwidth, and every now and then it would lag or it would freeze up. It was just, they were using so much bandwidth at the time. So, and I also think that you tend to get less compression artifacts. You don't get any compression artifacts over optical disc, but you still kind of do over streaming. But that is going to change in the years to come. Now when we have HDMI 2.1 with eARC, eARC allows for lossless audio transmission. eARC has higher data rates. So as we see time progressing, I think we're going to eventually have Dolby True HD going through eARC, through streaming devices, so you have lossless audio in Atmos and beyond. But we're still years away from that, so at the time of making this video, I still say optical has many advantages. If you're a pure audiophile and a pure videophile, and you don't mind buying the physical disc that you want to enjoy for many years to come, optical is still the best way to go. But if you love binge watching your favorite shows, Lost in Space, whatever, these things look awesome on Netflix. Amazon Prime looks awesome. Hulu, Vudu, I mean, there's just so many options for streaming. You definitely want to have streaming in your system, but also still keep your optical player. I still have my Oppo UDP 205. I'll take that to the grave with me or until it breaks, because I love that player. So guys, I hope you find this video useful. Please thumb it up, please share it. Don't forget about our Patreon channel at patreon.com/audioholics. We're giving away free earbuds to anybody that becomes a patron. So you go to join our page to get them. We're going to be doing other contest giveaways soon. There's unique content on our Patreon channel that you don't always get on YouTube. And until next time, my friends, keep listening. Hey folks, I'm Gene Delisalo with Audioholics, and today we're going to be talking about streaming versus optical. What is better?